Hey guys, Balkan Architect here, and in today's video I'm going to be showing you how to create this really cool ceiling light inside of Revit. So I was scrolling through some interior design projects, and I've seen this really cool ceiling, and it has these very unique lights which are kind of embedded in the ceiling, and I thought that looks really cool. I decided to call it a lofted light. I don't know what would the name for this be, but yeah, that's what I'm going to use for this tutorial. So anyways, I'm just going to be showing you how to model something like this. Now before we actually jump into Revit, I would just like to take a moment to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up just below this video in the description, and then also up in the cards above. Now, on my website, you can find all of my Revit courses. For example, I have an entire course just dedicated to lights in Revit, and I show you everything you need to know when it comes to creating lighting inside of Revit. Also, on my website, you can find some ready-to-go customized Revit templates. You can find some really high-quality Revit families, and we also have a plugin which might interest you as well. Okay, now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And as you can see, here I am in Revit. I'm just at the home screen, so let's start a new project. Well, actually, this is going to be a new family, so let's go here to Families and then go to New. And then here I'm just going to search for a ceiling light. So here we have the lighting fixture ceiling based. So that's the one I want to use, and I'm using metric because, well, I use metric. So I'm just going to click OK, and let's let Revit start up. So this is what you get at the beginning. So if I go to the 3D view, basically you have this little light here. Oh, it's on the other side. Okay, so basically you have this light source, and then this is kind of there as a stand-in for the ceiling. So what you want to do is you want to find the elevations, and you want to open up the front elevation, and then you want to zoom in. Now for this type of a ceiling light, I'm just going to be using a revolve to create it. So that's just one of the forms that we have available here. So you just want to find revolve, click on that, and I first like to place my axis, that's usually what I do first, so I'm just going to select that, and then just create a simple axis line here in the middle. You're going to notice it's going to be like this kind of purple dashed line. So let's just place it there. Okay, so the next step is to do the boundary. So for the boundary, I'm just going to go here to the boundary line, and then I like to come here from the bottom, and then let's go up, I don't know, like 180 centimeters, and then let's go out for about 120, for example, click, and now hit the escape key a couple of times. Next, you want to switch here to the arc tool. You want to use the first one, so the start and radius arc. So you want to click on that, you want to click here, and then go at a 45 degree angle until you get to that ceiling, click, and then you make just a 90 degree arc, and then hit the escape key a couple of times. Then you want to go here to the pick lines tool, set an offset to whatever you want the thickness of your ceiling to be. So for example, if I want my ceiling to be like 5 centimeters, I'm just going to use that. So I'm just going to go here with 5 centimeters, or 50 millimeters in this case, and then just offset this, and then offset it up here. Now in this case it went like this, it looks a bit silly, so I'm just going to drop it back here and then use a straight line to kind of finish that there, and then also use a straight line to complete that shape here. Finally, I'm just going to be using trim and extend to corner here to fix this, and use a simple line here to cap this edge. Okay, so once we have this in place, now I can hit finish, and it's going to create that light here, and it's going to look like that. Of course, you can make it larger if you want, you can make it smaller if you want. This is the size that I went with for this particular demonstration. Now, you also want the lights, the light to actually kind of have that, well, either a light bulb, or is it like an LED panel or something like that. Well, that actually needs to be there modeled as part of the family. So we need to do that. But we also want to poke a hole through the ceiling. So let's do the hole first, and then I'll show you how to make the actual light. This is just kind of the framing for the light, I guess. So let's go here to create, then you go to void forms, because you're, well, creating a void through the ceiling, so you just go there, you go to extrusion, and then you want to set the work plane to be the ceiling. So luckily here we have it named reference plane ceiling, perfect, click OK. And then here you just wanna go and you can use pick lines and pick out this line and this line. There we go. Then the extrusion end, we can leave it to 50. That's perfectly fine. Or let's go with something smaller like 50. Hit apply. Okay, and it's going to appear somewhere over there. Let's see, where is this void? Okay, there it is. So we have that void there in place. Now you can see that it's kind of cutting our light and we don't want that. So we can actually fix that by going here to geometry and going to cut, expand that, go to uncut, select our light, select the void, and now we have the void as kind of a separate entity. Now you want to go again to cut and you want to select the ceiling and select the void, and now what you'll see is now we actually have that opening and we can see the light here. Okay, for the next step, you want to go here to ceiling plans, reflected ceiling plan, and then you can see here this is kind of that light that we have. So you want to go here to create, and then you want to create an extrusion, but you want to go first to the 3D view and then use the set work plane, pick a plane, and then pick this plane here in the middle. It's only going to highlight like a half circle. That's perfectly fine. So you click there and then you go back to your reflected ceiling plan and then you just create a circle. I'm not going to go all the way to the edges. I like to go a little bit towards the inside like so. And then let's give it an extrusion end of 20 millimeters, for example. So this is like a circular LED panel that goes into this housing, for example. Okay, so let's hit finish, go to the 3D view, and this is what we have. See how that's now inside of that housing, we have that LED panel. Now it makes sense to assign materials as well. So this being that light source or that LED panel, you want it to actually glow in the dark. And we actually have a material for that. So you go here, you select it, you go here to the properties panel, you go to material, you click, and then you go to glass. So you search for glass, and then if I expand this here, I think towards the bottom, we have this glass white high luminance. So this is actually a glowing material. I'm not sure if it's going to show it here on the image. You can see it's updating. Yeah, so as you can see, it's just going to be glowing. So let's load that in, that glowing material. Now keep in mind, it's not going to cast any light. It's just going to appear as it's glowing without casting light. Unfortunately, it doesn't cast light. I think it does if you're using some sort of an external rendering engine like V-Ray or I don't know, Enscape or something like that. But with Revit, it's not going to cast light. It's only going to glow kind of on its own. And then let's hit apply, okay, and there we go. So now this is going to be our light source or our LED panel. Now for this part, we actually just want it to be part of the ceiling, and I know my ceiling is going to be gypsum, so let's search for gypsum. Gypsum wallboard, load that in, hit apply, okay. And there we go, perfect. And then finally, we want to set our light source. So you can go to one of the elevations, and I actually like to place my light source well inside of this thing. So well inside of the housing. The reason for that is because I want to make sure that it's actually casting light inside of this thing and not only below. And you might think, well, we can switch to another light source. I have tried that. So for example, if you go with something like this, like a spotlight, okay, so if you, let's modify it just to go straight down. So when you have a spotlight that's off kind of at an angle like this, see how it's kind of going off to the side, you can go here to family types and then just set the tilt angle to 90 degrees, which is just going to make it go straight down. Now the problem with this, it's only going to be casting light below but not inside of this housing, and that's not going to look accurate when you render. So you want to select that, go back here to light definitions, and then you can perhaps use this. So this could work, or I just use like a regular sphere, and that works perfectly fine. Now in terms of this light, if I go back here to family types, you can actually modify some of the photometrics. So I explain all of this in my course on lighting. So just to kind of keep it simple here, if you want to kind of increase the power, you can do that here. You can change the color here. So for example, I actually like something a bit more kind of white, so for 4000 or something like that. Fluorescent, no, let's go with xenon, gives you like perfect white. So let's go with that. Okay, so once I'm happy with that, I can hit apply, click OK, and now our light is ready. So let's now save this family. So let's go here to save, and then I'm just going to save it on my desktop, and let's call it my light family or something like that. Lofted. Okay, so once I'm happy with that, I can just hit save, and then let's start a new project. So file, new project, and I'm just going to be using my architecture design template, the metric version. If you want to check out my templates, I'm just going to link those up in the cards above. Anyways, let's just now click OK. So that's going to open up a Revit project. Here I'm just going to be placing some walls. So let's go to level 1, let's get rid of the starting view, let's go to walls, and let's just use some external walls. Yeah, so just a rectangle like so. Maybe make it a bit smaller. Okay, get rid of one of the walls so we can render it a bit easier. And then let's add a floor here. So just a rectangle like so. And then let's make it just, we can make it wood. And then for the ceiling, let's go to the ceiling, sketch ceiling. And I'm just going to be using this plain ceiling. Now, before I place it, I like to check the thickness, which is 5.7, which is 0.7 centimeters larger or thicker than I want it to be because of my light, where I've modeled it to be 5. So I'm just going to go here to edit structure and change this by 2. So let's actually drop this by 0.5 and this one by 0.2. So now when I click OK, that gives me that perfect 5. Let's now hit apply, OK, and let's use a simple rectangle here. Oops. Rectangle like so. OK, hit finish, and let's go to the 3D view. Oops, not that one. So let's go back to the project, and here let's go to the 3D view, and let's bring the ceiling up just a little bit. So let's go to 280, for example. Okay, so once we have the ceiling in place, now it's time to place our lights. So let's go back to the light, go to load into project. So it's going to load it back in here, go to the 3D view, and now we can just start placing it here on the ceiling. So as you can see, that's what this is going to look like. You can also go to the ceiling view or the ceiling plan, and then here you can start placing those lights. You can kind of have some sort of order when it comes to placement. Something like that, I don't know. So whatever you're trying to do, you can do it here. And then let's select them like this. And we can just kind of move them around. But anyways, now we have those lights in place. Let's select these, place them like that. And now let's do our test rendering. So I'm just going to go here to level 1. And then let's create a camera view here. So something like that. And we can see these lights here. But what I want to do is I'm just going to go here to the navigation wheel and then look up, maybe move in a little bit, and then I'm just going to go down. So here you have up, down, so you can kind of move down. I'm just going to go almost to the ground and then I'm going to look up. So the reason why I'm doing this is I actually want to see that light source. So this is our kind of LED panel. So I just want to show you how that will render. So anyways, let's just kind of adjust the view like this. And then we can kind of expand it a little bit if we want to see more. But I think this is fine. Okay, and now let's render. So for the rendering, I'm just going to go here to, let's see, let's go to view. And then not view, view. Okay, yeah, here we go. Render, RR is the shortcut. And then here, let's set it to medium, print 300 DPI, which is what I usually like to use. And then really important here for lighting, you wanna make sure you set it to interior artificial only. So interior basically means kind of the contrast and the lighting settings. And then the artificial light means that it's going to have only the artificial light, and it's not going to give you a kind of a sun light source. So let's just keep it at that, and then let's hit render and see the results. And this is the result that we get. So as you can see, the light looks exactly how it should, where it's really bright around these edges here, and then it slowly fades out. We can also see that it's very white, which is of course because we have set it to that 6000 Kelvin value. And of course you can play around with the brightness and everything as you would like. I have shown you all of those settings. Now, if you want to get this family, you can find that on my Patreon page, which I'm going to link up just below this video in the description, and then also up in the cards above. There you can find all of my Revit project files. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.